Virgin, Rough Riders, Interscope, Independent. I don't care. It doesn't matter to me. Yeah. The music matters, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. The next project from Jen is gonna be incredible, B. It's gonna be crazy. Cause he already knows what he wants now. Yeah. He knows, like, even if you left it up to him, if you said if you had a chance to take off any songs, he'll take off wild songs, B. He'll probably only leave the hot shit, like the fucking Twisted shit is hot. He'll leave fucking Cold Outside, the same cry about the Asian movement, the thank you shits, you know, Love Story he'll leave. You know, the heartfelt ones, the ones that move you, you know what I'm saying? And then take all those other shits off and replace them with fucking MC Slang atrocities, man. You feel me? That's all we want, B.
Just your story is going to be unique. There's going to be some comparisons made that you probably already aware of, because you probably had those comparisons made already. The Eminem thing, because the fact is, you jumped into a black world and made yourself blacker than black.
Oh, wow. Yeah, well, I mean, comparisons are always made, and as you know, them calling me like the Chinese Eminem and all that, he sounds like Eminem, he's that. It's not the first time that comparisons have been made in hip hop, so you know, I don't feel bitter about it in that way. But what's important though is that people do realize at some point that Jin is Jin, and Jin is nobody else, and nobody else is Jin. There's only one Ron.
Well, yeah, it's good.
No, same questions.
Jesus. Let me interview my
When did you start rapping? Who inspired you? How does it feel to be the first Asian rapper? Is this your first time in Taiwan? Anything?
One of the secretaries came out and said, "Hey, Carl, D Chow needs to talk with you." And D Chow, she's pretty much like the head of Asia, you know, based in Hong Kong. Who handled a lot of the Jin tour, and you know, on the side of the EMI and the label. And you know, D got on the phone with me and she was like, you know, "Carl, we got a problem." And then I was like, you know, "What's going on?" And then she was just like, "Carl, we got a problem in Singapore right now. You need to talk to the promoters."
That might be some situation where, you know, there's some misunderstanding there as well.
Because for some reason, you know, they're threatening to cancel the whole thing. And so I was like, you know, "What's going on over here?" And then
two problems.
What's the problem? Singapore.
Let me ask you a question. If there's anything that they set up that's conflicting with what you guys have, anything conflicting, how do you explain it, Carl?
Anything conflicting, like, anything, does it run into, I mean, is it going to compete with your event?
Yeah, is anything that we do competing with?
But basically, it's like we are paying for Jin to come down and the hotel and everything.
The hotel is covered, though. The hotel is covered.
Yeah, covered by
for one day,
yeah.
But your side. I know, your side. The first
day. We're covering
tomorrow?
For 2 days.
No, the first day is good. First day is good. Right, I told you, like, I never asked you for that extra.
I paid for 2 days.
Oh, they never got you?
No, they never covered anything for us.
So basically what happened was this, you know, Li Feng had this show. You know, he worked really hard for this. You know, he worked really hard. You know, he brought the artists here, and then, you know, their EMI scheduled a lot of these other things for Jin. And so, you know, they scheduled Xbox release, they scheduled like a lot of press conference, etc.
You tune in to MTV Cool Crap, that's right. The only show where you get to win cool crap from every artist that you've ever thought about having some crap from. So today, I'm about to give away this crap right here.
And then, you know, Li Feng felt that, you know, hey, if you guys are gonna capitalize on this kind of stuff, why should I have to pay for everything? And so Li Feng felt that maybe he should have been compensated from the EMI side on some of the, you know, tour expenses.
So if there's anything that, how can I say it, that's conflicting, that's gonna compete with what you're doing, then let us know so that we can tell them we can't do that because it's competing with the promoter. You understand?
Big picture, you know, I think he didn't see that, you know, by having Jin go to these Xbox things, having him go to these Reebok things, that would help support that party as well.
You're one of the parking lot fans?
Yeah. Where? I am the parking lot fan.
You're one of the fans?
Yeah, come on, yeah. You know Jin, the freestyle king, and AKA the rap Yao Ming. Champion, and I need more rings, but it's so natural, like the way Paul sings. It's bigger than a hip hop thing, whether if you do or you don't got wind. Do what I do, ain't no stopping. Just the way I am, got the world watching.
I do what I wanna do, just let me be, that's just the way I am.
Pinterest thing. Okay.
Alright. Yeah. Say something for me.
Can I get a discount?
You gonna get a discount?
Yeah.
Just for you. I can give you $1 off.
$1 off?
Is it you?
Yes.
I wouldn't take this if you gave it to me for free.
Free cannot, because we are retail shop.
No, of course not. No. Don't give it to nobody for free. Sell it.
We were shopping in Singapore, and then we walked to one of the shops, and we're like, oh shit, it's raining.
It's not gonna be as many people, though.
Right?
It's raining, but then we're still going.
I don't know.
I mean, basically, it might have just killed the show that night.
Yo, Oak, let's go. Uh-huh. It's a new era. K-1. Rough Riders. Most of y'all all sound the same. Put your hands in cars and your diamond rings.
It's a collab, like from an event company. So basically, they just put us together. They thought it might be interesting, like just put us together and do a show. So.
Now this is exclusive for G.
I think it's still at a stage where they don't know what really is hip-hop yet, you know, like besides the bling, besides this, you know, they don't know what's going on yet, you know, like, so people don't listen to the lyrics yet, you know, they don't listen it to that much, like pay attention to the lyrics yet, like people are still into the whole pop thing. You, like in Singapore, you cannot like just be hip-hop and feed your family yet. You know, so basically I think it's still in the process of building up right now, yeah.
Yo, it's 12 o'clock, finished up another gig. Willie Nelson got me singing on the road again. I'm home soon and I love you too. On the cheek, grabbed my bag and left the room. Another day, no dollar, but I love what I do. You know a soldier gonna miss that.
We made it. Here we are, Tokyo.
Just got on the plane, about to check into the hotel, do it real big. My man Yosuke right here. The man. Say what's up to the camera, man.
Yo, what's up? I'm a Japanese promoter here. Yeah. I'll definitely promise Jin and everyone that you guys are gonna have a great time in Japan.
Shock right now. I don't know what to make of all this.
There are only like 10,000 fucking.
We've got the Shibuya. I'm looking for sneakers. Like that's like one of the top agendas in like every one of our stops.
Everybody knows, that a lot of the sneakers are made in China, made in Japan, made in here, made in there. So being that we was all the way over there, we figured we would find some of the more exclusive kicks.
Scheming on the blue and white Dunk Highs. They're $1,400, $14,000.
There are a couple of types of like hip hop fan, like the people who likes the fashion and the culture of hip hop and listen to the new tracks kind of. And the second type is like, you know, really like to kind of communicate through Japanese language and like a Japanese hip hop kind of.
Did you grow up in Tokyo?
Yeah.
How do you speak English so well?
I grew up over here till like junior high, and then I left for quite some reasons. And then went to Boston for a little bit, chilled up in New York, stayed in Brooklyn, and went to school.
Yo. It's like one for the money, two for the show, three for hip hop, on four, let's go. This shit is worldwide, from China to Tokyo. Yo.
First of all, I didn't even understand the language. You know what I mean? Coming from here, it's just, first it was like the visual, you know, it's like Public Enemy. You got Flavor Flav with like a fucking big ass clock and like, you know, like yellow suit and just funky, you know what I mean? And it's just they really can't understand why we doing it over here, you know what I mean? Let's say in our language, or they're like, yo, you ain't bro, you ain't from the streets. I ain't from there, but I'm from the streets over here, you know what I mean? We ain't trying to like take over hip hop or nothing, you know? It's just love, you know?
All of them are still growing. But Japan, like, they seem to be very, like, hands-on, like, with the DJing, with the B-boys.
New York.
Audience, the size of the fans and everything like that, we're working to get it bigger.
Lately we've been sleeping from like 9 o'clock to like 1:30 in the morning, waking up, shooting straight to the club. So it's like you're sleeping 1 minute, 15 minutes later after you wake up, you're in the club where all of this shit is happening. It's kind of mind-boggling. I don't like that. So I'm trying to get it to where we can get up earlier, get to the club at least 45 minutes before performance.
To adjust.
Yo, how about we get to the club, like, let's just say like 12:45 type shit, if your performance is like 1:20.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because I even noticed with you,
I think
when you walk in a club, your attitude is real mean. Like, you notice that lately? You come in grumpy. And next thing you know, they're like, so we're gonna get on in a few. It's like, we don't really
know. Yo,
like,
say, yo,
like, back the fuck up both of us. On our way to the show.
We're going to Shibuya Nuts. Ready to go.
We're here. So up the line.
Go to the.
What's going on?
Japan, you gotta go raw, man.
Tokyo, yo. Japan, make some fucking noise, y'all!
Oh shit, sounds crazy.
I was doing something in the house, and I got you in my ankle, my father's in the mouth.
How it look, boss?
You ain't stopping the work. Hit me at the club like tweet, dropping his skirt.
Oh, yeah, get ready for Virginia!
Make some fucking noise,
Okay? Yeah, Chinese.
Put your fucking hands up, let's go.
I had no clue what was going on. We relied on the promoters, we relied on Yosuke to do all the translation.
Yo, Yosuke, how do you say sleeping? Yosuke, I need your help.
Yosuke, Yosuke, how do you say what's up? Chōshū. Chōmea means chōshū. Okay? So check it, ready? Say the next part. Mou ye, mou ye.
Mou ye, mou ye.
Yosuke. That means, how do you say? Nothing, nothing.
Ain't nothing, it's all right.
全身大丈夫, right? So ready, 救命啊, 某爷某爷, so I say to you, Saga City, 救命啊, one more time, 救命啊, 某爷某爷,
there was a big ass gap on the stage. I was just backing up and I fucking fell.